Gentle tidings, folks. Welcome to a bike hike adventure in New England.
Hey there, YouTubers. Me and Sean. Hey there. Please like and subscribe.
With my cousin.
Sean, where are we going today? Which is a nice New England hill for you.
Pardon the wind noise. We had to do these on the old iPhones. Not that my audio is ever any good anyway. I love getting out this time of year when the leaves go down just before the snow comes. You actually get views, not just a wall of leaves. Yeah, that's me, looking forward to the hike. It actually was. Warms up the feet.
A little chilly over there.
I did not expect there to be snow up here. It's actually been pretty mild thus far. But of course, on the north faced slope, there was some snow and ice, you know, just enough to make it a little bit slippery, but, you know, we were riding Ultra Dynamico, a race compound. You know about that stuff, it's the best. I heard somebody rode up the side of the Empire State Building on them recently.
I don't mind the hiking, even though I'm saying it now, it's dynamic in the ice, you know? The dynamic scramble.
That's me talking about the ice. Not a bad view, you know?
And that's the end of the riding part.
Without aluminum, I wouldn't try this. I wouldn't try this.
Well, who can argue with that? You know, once you commit to hiking with your bike, knowing that you're going to be doing it for a few hours, it's not that bad.
At the summit, we're going to see how this trail goes. That was not bad. It was a little icy coming up, but it's beautiful. It's a beautiful day up here. And now we're going to go walk our bikes down. But it's nice. We're making these little connectors. Ran into one hiker. It's real nice. I'm kind of confused as to what we were doing. But, you know.
Oh yeah. Oh, yep, now we're rock crawling, baby. Now, to me, this is the most fun you could have on a bike. Classic New England single track. Raw, rugged, and just a little bit faster than walking. It's a full body workout, with the side effect of building a hot bod in the winter that you could later sculpt.
And I'm gonna say that this is the last of the climb down. You had to do a good deal of it. Oh, that must feel good.
From here, the trail became moderately rideable in a classic sense. A few dabs here and there, but no one's looking. Well, let's cut to Ronnie live on the scene for a little explanation of what can happen if you get a little overzealous on this rough stuff.
Not enough traction there. So yeah, you'd have to pretty much have a full commitment to this. Oh, yep, you'd be right here. Oh, that little divot. Oh, front wheel. That's a deep one. And you just completely rearrange your face on this rock.
Okay, well, thank you, Ronnie.
That's why we're walking it.
That's why we're walking, folks. Love crawling downhill on upright handlebars. Allow you to really get that front end of your bike elongated. Thank you. Thank you. Don't applaud, just throw money. By this waterfall. I didn't expect that. Little product placement. That is, of course, the Alumalith, available from ronsbikes.com, the premier ATV platform. Made in Vermont by Frank the Welder. For Ron's Bikes and Crest Bikes.
Sometimes you get the ATV, sometimes the ATV gets you.
Indeed it does.
Well, it is. Lightweight, baby. Yeah.
Just trying to climb up to the parking lot here. It's a good thing it didn't happen earlier on.
Yeah,
we still had 25 miles to go though, so we were able to temporarily fix this by jamming a thumb-sized twig through the length of the saddle. Was able to support it. Got him back. Sean never complains though. Sean, of course, he went all out on this bike, making it as light as possible, which certainly comes in handy when you're carrying it half the day. But my bike was pretty light too, though, and I didn't have to ride home on a stick. I was beginning to get pretty tired here, as I recall. Let's go to old Ronnie live on the scene and see how it's going for him.
Final stretch, about 10 miles to go. We get to some very, very fine grain, single origin gravel. Strada Bianca style. Pretty close, actually.
What?
You're pretty close.
Yeah, we're pretty close. We're almost there.
Starting
to be able to taste
the
pizza on my
taste pad.
Pizza timer activated.
It's so cute out here.
It really is cute. So, with the pizza timer activated, I start getting pretty tired. But the scenery keeps me alive. And the promise of hot pizza.
I just popped. Elastic band officially snapped on. I've lost contact with my young cousin.
Yep, he's way the heck up there. But I don't think that I had a bowel movement there, but I wouldn't put it past me. Just shifted into my 2032 there. That's the end of a long day. Glad I have that gear. The end of a fine day. Thanks for taking me out, Sean. Here are the photos I took out there with my Fuji X100F. A very popular camera on TikTok now, so I hear. I tried to use it as the video camera also, but it did not work so well, so I did the video with iPhones. I hope this inspires you to go out and carry your bike over something, and ride it down the other side possibly. Get off your bike whenever you see a hiker or an equestrian. Wish them a fine day. Tell them you hope they have the hike or ride of their lives. Smile and carry on. Thank you, folks. I hope you have a wonderful evening. I'm Ronnie Romance, and this is my YouTube channel.